Okay, let's talk about pi for a minute. You remember pi, right? The number of times bigger a circle's circumference is than its diameter. It's a little more than 3. We could call it 3.14, or 3 1/7, and be accurate enough for most applications. You could use 39 decimal places and be accurate enough for all applications. But pi's digits keep going, forever, and they're random. So this means you can find your birthday in pi. Mine occurs at the 33,870th decimal place. But what about something longer, like your phone number? My 7-digit phone number doesn't occur within the first 1,000,000 decimal digits. But because the digits are random and unending, I'm certain to find it if I look far enough. In fact, for this reason, you can find any number you look for somewhere in pi. Now let's switch to binary for a bit. Pi looks like this now. The digits are just zeros and ones, but they're still random and unending. And this means that any given sequence of digits will turn up if you look far enough down the line. Computer files are just binary strings, so we could find your favorite MP3 somewhere in pi. We could find a picture of you in there, or a picture of what you'll look like in 10 years. It's not likely that we'll find a particular sequence of digits quickly, but we can rest assured that it's in there somewhere. There's the sound of your first words in there. There's the video of your 10th birthday party. Your DNA is in pi, along with the DNA of every other creature. Every YouTube video, every Wikipedia article, every piece of information that will ever exist is sitting there, already, somewhere in those digits. So think about that the next time you see the circle.